Hello guys, it's Ming here featuring the new iPhone 6 Plus. This is the new premium iPhone with a bigger 5.5-inch HD display. One thing you should really know about this phone is that it is really big. The iPhones are again available in three different colors, silver, gold, and space gray. I have the silver color version which we are gonna take a look in this video and to find out why size does really matter. Once again, let's begin the unboxing process before we get into the spec details. A first look into the box reveals a simplistic and minimalist design, with an embossed iPhone feature at the front. All iPhones of all kinds are packed into the same box, and for that you can't tell what iPhone color or capacity is in the box. However, you can find this information on the sticker at the back, so be careful and know what you are buying. Alright, so back to the box, and let's start by removing the lid with both hands, and here we go, as simple as 1, 2, 3. Here we have the brand new pristine iPhone 6 Plus. My first impression, very thin and lighter than I expected. Better grip and way too big for my hands. Alright, so let's go ahead and explore more of the stuff in the box. Here we have the iPhone tray, with an extrusion here for the protruding camera. What we'll find in this envelope here are some Apple stickers, quick start guide, and basic regulatory information. Further down inside, we have our standard 3-pin Apple charger. We also have a set of Apple AirPods which I never use, and then we have our lighting to USB cable. Next, let's go ahead and turn the iPhone on for a close examination. Let's start with design. The iPhone 6 Plus is taller, wider, and thicker than the iPhone 6. The additional size makes it less ergonomic in terms of handling, but to compensate this, the edges are rounded and smooth, similar to the iPad mini and Air, which gives a more comfortable grip. At the back of the iPhone, we will find that iconic Apple logo in stainless steel. On the left hand side are a newly designed volume control and a mute switch. At the bottom, of course, we have our lighting connector and also a newly designed speaker holes, which are larger now and makes the iPhone a loudspeaker in its own right. On the left, we have the headphone jack and also the tiny microphone. Along the right hand side, you will find the reposition power button, which has been moved from the top to the right side, making it easier to reach with the thumb. I'm not quite sure if this is a direct copy of Samsung phones. On this side also, we will find the SIM tray which houses a nano SIM. Overall, the sense you get with the iPhone 6 Plus is one of extreme high design quality. The very reason that this phone is so big is the 5.5-inch 1920x1080p Retina display. It's the highest pixel density screen ever in an iPhone at 401 ppi. By comparison, the iPhone 6 and 5s only have 326 ppi. It is definitely brighter and sharper than previous Retina display. The larger screen allows for greater productivity and media consumption. Browsing the web, looking at photographs, reading, and watching videos on a mobile device has never been this pleasant and joyful since the introduction of the mobile tablet. The extra size of the screen means that the home display is optimized to be used in both landscape mode as well as portrait mode. The iPhone 6 Plus also presents a new feature called reachability. By double tapping the home button, you can bring everything down for a better reachability with the thumb. The larger screen size also takes advantage of a new landscape keyboard, which comes with a new cut, copy, and paste button. Overall, I have to say that the bigger screen is the unique selling point of the iPhone 6 Plus. Alright, let's now take a look at the camera. It is still 8 megapixels, but Apple has added a new camera feature, what it calls the focus pixels. It enables twice as fast autofocus, face detection, and exposure control than the iPhone 5S. The video that you're seeing right now is captured at 1080p HD at 60 frames per second. In case if you're wondering where I took the shots, it was the SS2 Night Market. The autofocus works so quickly that the changes are barely noticeable. The quality of the video is incredible even in low light. In terms of photos, the iPhone 6 Plus have an exclusive feature called the optical image stabilization, which makes the camera a champion than the iPhone 6 in taking low light shots. It functions like a gimbal as shown with the drone for the lenses and help take more stable photos by eliminating the blur caused by small hand movements. Another great feature to the line is the ability to shoot HD videos at either 120 frames per second or 240 frames per second in 720p, which is twice the capability of the iPhone 5S at a max of 120 frames per second. With 240 frames per second, a much slower and smoother video is possible in slow motion. This feature is the coolest among the others as it allows you to capture things such as dogs' reaction to treats or even intense dog fights. Apple offers the flexibility to select the portion you wish to slow down or change which section of your film is in slow motion at any time. In addition to the rear camera, we also have an improved front-facing camera. It is still 1.2 megapixels and captures videos at 720p HD. However, it features a new sensor which allows it to capture 81% more light for a better quality video, and also an improved face detection for a more rapid autofocus. For those selfie enthusiasts out there, there's a new burst mode which captures 10 pictures per second for a perfect selfie project. You may then select the best photo out of the burst for your own sweet pleasure. Keep everything. Yeah. The HD FaceTime camera also features an auto HDR, which gives a better dynamic range, giving a noticeably better looking live feed of yourself to your partner, especially when using Skype or FaceTime. There seem to be no end to the options of taking selfies. So when recording a video of yourself, you can snap some photographs of yourself by just pressing the icon below here. Now let's have a look at performance. Apple's new A8 processor uses a 64-bit dual-core 1.4 GHz CPU with a quad-core GPU, supported by 1 GB of RAM, which claims to be 50 times faster than the first iPhone 7 years ago, and 50% more energy efficient than the A7 chip on the iPhone 5S. Apple presents a new API for what it calls Metal. Metal is optimized to allow the CPU and GPU to work together to deliver detailed graphics and complex visual effects. It's like unlocking the secret graphic performance on the A8 chip. That's good news if you like console-style gaming on your phone. If you are interested, this racing game is called Asphalt Airborne and runs exclusively on the Metal API. Despite tasked with a more difficult job to push significantly more pixels on the screen, the iPhone 6 Plus battery seems to last forever. It comes equipped with a larger battery owing to its larger size, with a 3000 mAh battery, which is 30% more than the iPhone 6 capacity. This adds to the convenience, especially if you are a heavy user and you find yourself outdoors most of the time. I could use the phone almost for the entire day without worrying about it dying out of battery capacity. Okay, here is the verdict. Personally, I love the size of the iPhone 6 Plus. I think 5.5 inches is perfect for the size of my hand. My hands are quite large, so it's nice to have a larger keyboard, a lot more room for displaying content and interacting with the display. Besides the full 1080p display and optical image stabilization, perhaps one of the biggest reasons to consider the iPhone 6 Plus over the iPhone 6 is the extra battery capacity. The longer battery life with the convenience it brings really justify the extra cost of the iPhone 6 Plus. If you are a power user, then the iPhone 6 Plus is probably the one you're gonna want. If you're ever going to get one, I recommend going for the 64GB version as the minimum storage capacity. The 16GB version only have 11GB of usable memory, which isn't much for almost anything. Overall, the iPhone 6 Plus is a great smartphone and certainly a worthy long-term investment. Alright guys, so that concludes my unboxing and review of the iPhone 6 Plus. I hope you guys enjoy it as I've made some improvements over my first unboxing and review of the 5K iMac. If you're interested to see what the changes are, please click on the link beside me. And also if you're interested to see my grandma's obese cat video, there's also a link beside me. And finally, I'd like to present to you Jack as a way to say thank you for watching.